What happens when your tabletop gaming career is almost decided by one role? Let me describe the situation. Let's go way back in time. Wizards has just re-released or revised Advanced Dungeons & Dragons 2nd Edition, and it feels like a good time to try it out. As any good little fantasy nerd could tell you, they probably knew what D&D was from Nerd Osmosis, but probably couldn't tell you anything more than the basic concept. So too was my current exposure. And I had always wondered what wonders those boxes held, adorned with monsters and heroes you see behind the counter at any respectable hobby shop. I had saved up months of allowance and birthday money, spare change picked off the ground, and the few bucks my dad gave for helping him with lawn care that he provided for the elderly neighbors. I took it all, and in traditional childhood fashion, rushed off and bought the current player's handbook without really thinking of it beyond it being something I wanted. I spent so many nights rereading it and imagining all the exciting adventures I would have. I hadn't even thought about finding a group yet. I asked around at school, and while some people had no idea what I was talking about, others would laugh at me for being interested in such a hobby rather than lighting firecrackers or pelting rocks at one another. Eventually, I found someone. A friend of a friend who knew someone's cousin whose older neighbor played. The days before there was a computer in every home, right? So this older kid, named Justin, would be the entrance into the real D&D reality. We met and bonded, and I found him to be a cool dude. He told me about his group and how they met around Saturday afternoon to play. I begged my mom to let me go, but she was skeptical as to why I needed to play a board game with these older boys she didn't know that lived downtown. For clarification, she both knew and liked Justin, even if he was about 4 to 5 years older than me. Why couldn't I just play with my friends? Well, Mom, not a single one was interested in playing, and no one had the patience to learn it. Eventually, she relented and said I could go after my usual Saturday chores. I must have woken up at 5 to do those chores and redid them just to make sure I wouldn't be late. She drives me downtown, picks up Justin, and takes us to this 3-story old Victorian-esque home that Justin says his DM lives in. Mom kisses me goodbye and says to call when I'm ready to come and be picked up. So we enter, and the first thing I was greeted with was the scent of unwashed bodies. Each floor was rented out to college students, and in my young eyes, these were practically adults. Filthy, filthy adults. We went in and met a rather fat and greasy college senior, who we shall call Melvin. Melvin took one look at me and was not happy to see me. He asked me a few questions, you know, a little bit of gatekeeping, so the game wouldn't be slowed down. I passed all his questions with flying colors, and then he asked if I had my character sheet ready. I handed him my level 1 thief. He reviews it and tells me I'm too low level. I need to be much higher as he is in the midst of a 3-year-long campaign and he can't stop the momentum just for me. I quickly level and he says, okay, I can play. In half an hour, about 3 other people arrive and we talk while Melvin sets up his notes and DM screen. These guys are nice, friendly, and it looks like we're gonna have lots of fun. Then the game begins. For all Melvin's faults, he was a master storyteller. Everyone was instantly captivated when he began his epic level session. The party was in the midst of a massive dungeon, delving ever downwards to stop an ancient demigod from being awoken. Because if he did, he would bring with him an army of liches with him. Where was I? Well, I wasn't there yet, as the narrative flow could not be jeopardized so that I could just appear. I waited on the edge of my seat, surrounded by this captivating world and masterful role players as they met NPCs and fought encounters. 2 hours I waited. It felt so much longer than all the months I had waited, the months I spent learning, trying to find people to play with, and trying to get my mom to let me play. It felt so much longer. Eventually, the party found a series of prison cells, and while most were filled with corpses, they found me in very good health. I tried my best to live up to their role-playing, and some argued for me to be released, while others said that I could be a mole planted to spy and backstab them. Eventually, they released me by bashing in the old rusty cell doors. They gave me a dagger and told me that I better be useful. Being a thief, they sent me in first to check for traps and scout ahead. I did. I rolled my first ever D20 as part of a game, and I'll never forget that smiling 16 looking back at me. It was a joyous moment, but it would not last. Melvin checked his notes and told me I didn't find any traps. I beckoned the team forward as I led the way, springing a pitfall. This was not just any pitfall, mind you. As he rolled dice behind his screen, Melvin said,
"This magical pit leads down to the realm of fire. The trap consumes you and your thief is dead."
I was shocked beyond all belief. No saving throw? And with my modifiers, I should have been able to see a trap like that, especially with such a high roll. People protested, but Melvin held firm on his ruling. I was dead. There wouldn't be a second chance, and there would be no second introduction. I was dead and gone. If the rest of the party had a problem, well, they could leave. The party grew silent, sat back down, and after an internal debate about throwing away years of gaming for a little kid that they just met because the DM was being a bit harsh, decided to continue playing. I held back my tears, and Melvin made fun of me for being a crybaby. Justin said, maybe it wasn't such a good idea for me to sit in on the rest of the session, and led me to another room, where he set up the Nintendo 64 and let me play Mario Kart while he finished. I played, crying quietly as the tragedy of the short-lived thief quickly became forgotten in the next room. I still heard them over the game, the cheers, the role-playing, and their triumph as they managed to stop a cult leader who was instrumental in resurrecting the demigod. Not the end of the campaign, but a decisive blow against the forces of evil. After 6 hours, Justin came out. We gathered our things and said goodbye to the guys who were going to go out for a few beers. Melvin sneered and asked,
"Did you enjoy the game?"
I didn't answer and just left. I never went back there or saw Melvin again. Over time, Justin and I just drifted apart after his family moved across the country, and I nearly never played another tabletop RPG again. So, to sum things up, a 20-year-old DM insta-kills a 9-year-old's character during their first ever session. This is one of the worst DMs ever. Again, this was back in the old days, but sometimes people need to have more compassion to those who are interested in something. When you play D&D, you can't be simple-minded and think only about selfish interests. When you play D&D with others, you are an ambassador to the game. Anything you do can either promote the game in a positive or negative light. We should bring more people into the hobby, not gatekeep. What do you all think about this situation?